Guys, welcome to the chapter 2 in machine learning that we are discussing. So in this chapter 2, we are going to discuss about importantly on neural network category. So in earlier sessions, what we have taken is we have taken the training data, we have taken the learning rule. From the training data and learning rule, we have modeled the system. So here, there was supposed to be a model here, but since we are discussing about neural network, the model is here in neural network. So how the neural network and how it looks like, you know, basically this neural network is something similar to the brain, you know, like in a human brain, there are so many nerves are there in the human brain, but the human brain doesn't have a capability to store the information. Instead, it has the capability to transmit the information from one neuron to other neuron based up depending upon its weight or action. The output will happen. So in the similar tune, people has defined the neural networks here. So how the neural networks here is takes place and how they are trying to compare the neural network with the with the brain is given a clear cut table here. So in this one, in the brains, there are so many billions of neurons that are there. So those are called as a nodes here, and so many connections are there. Those are called the connection weights here. And depending upon the type of activation, we are calling it a bias, or maybe some sort of we are giving some sort of additional bias information and we'll give some sort of activation here, and then we'll take the output. So we'll focus more on to this than we'll be understanding here. Say for example, so we'll first, you know, in earlier case, what we are taking is from the training data, from the training data, we are passing to the learning rule. From the passing learning rule, then we are finding the model. So instead the model here, we are using a neural network. From this neural network, we'll take some input data and we'll predict the output here. Okay, so the nodes of the neural network is as below. It is given here. So here, the inputs are, let us take some input. Let us take a simple neural network approach. In this, the inputs are x1, x2, and x3. And then each input is associated with a weight. That weight is w1, w2, and w3. So this x1, w1, x2, w2, x3, w3 is given to a summation point, and then you will be getting an output here. So how I'm able to trying to modify this in terms of equations is, so here you can see the output here is w1 x1 and the second thing that is coming here is w2 x2, and the third thing that is coming to here is w3 x3. So these are all summing here, so the entire sum is with the b, so this will become w1 x1 plus w2 x2 plus W3 X3 plus B is equal to the output. So I mean, like I can say that the output is here. So this is the output that is coming here that I am considering as a V. So that is what we are writing here. V is equal to W1 X1 plus W2 X2 plus W3 X3 plus B. Now, because you know our system is more and more focusing on, because we are trying to use either Python or MATLAB or LabVIEW, so we basically works on the matrix formats. So this I want to change this into a matrix format here. That's the reason why I'll take that this one is a row vector, other one is column vector. So that W as a row vector, I'll take as W is equal to W1, W2, W3, whereas X is equal to, as a common vector, X is equal to X1, X2, and X3. So V is equal to WX plus B. So now the output is depending upon the input. That is means the output of the function is phi of the input that we are getting. The input that we are getting here. So this means there may be some activation function, and based on that, the output is getting obtained. So this is the very, very basics of the neural network. If you understood this, the further things are quite easy here. So here, let us take a simple neural network approach, and then we'll try to solve what are the different type of neural networks are there. So in the neural networks, there are different layers of the neural networks. So one is, you know, initially what is happening, there were only a simple single layer neural network. In the single layer neural network, what the things are there, only there is an input layer and the output layer. So in the single layer neural network, there is only inputs are there and there are outputs. That's it. There is nothing in between them. So till late 2000s, so the people are still thinking about the single layer neural network are the much better, and they are able to give the relatively good output. And later they have transferred the single layer neural network depending upon the problem. You know, there are so many locations where the human intelligence is unable to figure out a problem in the form of an equation, where this was one of the prediction kind of technique where they are able to figuring out the problem. So then they have trying to identify a type of network called, it's called a multi-layer neural network. In the multi-layer neural network, there is input, there is output. In between, there is some sort of hidden layers here. This hidden means these are not all accessible to output. These are not accessible to the outside, but there are hidden in between them. So I mean, like, further the problem sizes increases and the people feel that there is a requirement to increase the number of hidden layers here, then they went to one more category, that is called deep neural network, where the hidden layers are more. It may be 2, it may be 3, it may be 4, it may be 5, it may be n number. So there is an input, so there may be inputs, there may be hidden layers here, there are two hidden layers, and there are the outputs, that is, that thus are getting obtained. So that is the basic classification between the single layer neural network and the multi-layer neural network. In the single layer neural network, there is an input layer and there is an output layer. Whereas in multi-layer neural network, there is two types of multi-layer neural networks are there. First type is shallow neural network. So you have to be very, very careful here. Shallow neural network is also called as a multi-layer neural network. Whereas here, there is only one hidden layer. If there are more number of hidden layers, then it is called as a deep neural network. See how simple it is. So deep neural network, deep machine learning algorithms. Deep means the more number of hidden layers. That is the reason why they are calling as a deep. Okay. Now let us take a simple example and then try to solve how the neural network is getting obtained, and then you'll get come to a basic amount of clarity you will get once you go through this sort of example. So here. So we will talk about one shallow type of neural network. There is an input, there is a hidden layer, there is an output. Okay. So here you observe. So input, it has 1 and input it has 2. So now this is a bias value 1 and the weights are 3, 2, 1, 4. These things are there. Okay. Now in this one, let me talk about first thing. Okay. So first, what is the output that is obtaining here? See, output that is obtaining here is this 1 is multiplied with 3. This is addition, right? And this 2 is multiplied with 1. Okay, so that is what? So the output at this first is 1 is multiplied with 3. And again, 2 is multiplied with 1. And having the sum here, it is 1. So here the value that you get is 6. So the same thing I am doing here, the calculation. 1 is multiplying with 3, 2 is multiplying with 1, and it is adding. So the value that is obtaining here, that is the output that is inside here. So the function here is v is equal to 6. Now let us take here. In this one, so let me erase this particular point and let me just put it here. Here, what are the things that is coming? The thing is that is coming is 1 is coming. So 1 is multiplied with 2. Plus 2 is multiplied with 4. So 1 is multiplied with this 2 is 2. And 2 is multiplied with 4 is 8. And 1 is also adding here. So 8 plus 2, 10 plus 1. So here the output is 11. Okay. So this is how you will simply make a structure. So now how do we represent in the form of a matrix? That is very, very simple. Now you see here. How things has coming. So from first thing, what are that going? So write that as a column matrix 3 and 2. And from second thing, what is that is going? Write it as a column matrix 1 and 4. Done. Having provided with inputs, that is 1 and 2. And their summation, whatever it is coming in the column matrix 1 and 1. So if you give the multiplication, 3 into 1 plus 1 into 2. 3 into 1 plus 1 into 2 plus 1, 6. 2 into 1 plus 4 into 2 plus 1, 11. Got it? So whatever you are trying to obtain here, you are obtaining from this directly. So that is how, you know, whatever the number of layers that are there inside, you don't need to worry at all. It's a very, very simple approach that where we can able to try to solve that very, very easily. Okay, so that is how. Now next, we'll target about here, next. In this next thing, how do you solve? So here 3 and 5 is there. So directly write first column, 3, 5. See here, 3 and 5. Whatever that is happening here, 3 and 5 is there. And here whatever happening here, 2 and 1, right? So earlier there was a 6 and 11, directly write 6 and 7, and thereby as 1 and 1. Absolutely we get 41, 42. That's it. So that means like what is happening here, so the biggest neural network, you can easily do that. Now, this is a simple neural network that I have told you to do this one and this one. So now, if, for example, if they give at a stretch like this, then this one I should convert into a very, very precise thing. Okay. And then how should I do that? Okay. But whatever it is, number maybe like. Okay. Now, firstly, what you have to do is you have to be very, very careful. So this is this entire thing is multiplying to this and then it is adding here, right? So first we'll write entire thing. So first you write what is the happening here entire. So what is happening entire here? So entire thing is multiplying, right? First we'll start from here, okay? So when you start from here, it is what are the things that are there? 3, 5, 2, 1. Because whatever the value that are coming here, it is getting multiplied here. So what are the values that are coming here? What are the values that are coming here? Values that are coming here is 3, 2, 1, 4. This is coming, okay? This is coming, having its input as 1 and 2, and it is having a bias of 1 and 1. So this total value is is multiplied here and summation with the output here 1 and 1. So you will get that same thing. So once again I'll tell you. So be clear about this, because this is very, very most and most critical point where you will be trying to solve this sort of problems. The first thing, so because see, this is coming and this coming is getting multiplied with the first. So the input layer and hidden layer is getting multiplied with the output layer, isn't it? So the output you have to write first. So this, what is the thing? That is 3, 5, 2, 1, you write here. This one, it should be multiply with everything which is besides here. So what is there inside besides here? That is 3, 2, 1, 4, it is there. And it is having a input of 1 and 2. And this is getting summation with 1 and 1 because it is having a bias. So this entire term is summation with here, right? That is 1 and 1. That's it. So now if you try to solve here, you will get that is something like 13. Here it is already there, 13. So this, if you try to solve these two, it will become 13, 11, 7, 9, having 1 and 2. And this if you solve here, you will get 6, 7. So the same thing you will write. So that is fine, perfect, all right. Okay, 3 into 1 plus 2 into 1 plus 1, that is 6. 5 into 1 plus 5, 1 into 1 plus 1, 7. That is how we will, compress. You know, if you want to compress the data of multi layers to a single layer, this is way how you can do it. So this is how the, you can apply the Python, or you can apply the MATLAB, or you can apply any sort of technique to solve this kind of approach. Okay. Now, so let us apply the same thing in terms of our supervised learning. Just I'll give a glimpse here, and then we'll discuss in the next video about this. In the supervised learning neural network, what are you giving is, you are giving certain amount of training data, that training data that is having input as well as correct output. And this will be given to an input as a input to the neural network. This is the neural network. This may be any type of neural network. It may be a shallow neural network, it is a multi-layer network, a deep learning neural network. There will be output. Okay. This output will be compared with the correct output. And then the error may be there. That error is passing and they will try to adjust the weight in this one. So just you remember at this particular point, like there is a output, there is a there is a correct output, and there is an error. Based on the error, the weights are getting adjusted inside the neural network. So till now you try to focus on this. In the next class we'll discuss, or in the next video I'll clearly tell how the weight is getting updated. That is most important thing here.